All right, hello everyone. Welcome to your week four factoring video. Now, factoring has several different parts to it, several different methods you can use to factor. So be sure to go through the readings and go through those extra videos to look at the different methods that can be used. I picked out a few examples that I thought might be helpful to you on your assignments. The first thing we always look for when we're factoring is a common factor. And we don't seem to have one here. We have x to the fourth minus y to the fourth. What this is called the difference because of subtraction of perfect squares. So we have the difference of perfect squares. X to the fourth is a perfect square because of x squared times x squared. And y to the fourth is a perfect square because of y squared times y squared. Now, the way we factor difference of squares is that we kind of take the square root. We'll say x squared plus y squared, because again, we said that this was x squared, and this was y squared. So we have x squared plus y squared times x squared minus y squared. Now you have to completely factor these problems, which means there may be more than one step to your factoring. In this case, we have difference of perfect squares again in this second binomial because we have subtraction, and x squared is a perfect square, so is y squared. So I have to use that difference of squares rule again. So therefore, this is x to the first squared, and this is y to the first squared, so I'll have x plus y, and then x minus y. Now this x squared plus y squared will just stay like it is, but we have to split this x squared minus y squared up into those two binomials there. Now I don't have any more difference of squares, don't have any common factors within the parentheses, so this would be my final answer for that one. So we use the difference of squares rule twice for this particular problem. Okay, factoring a trinomial with the coefficient of 1 in front of x squared. Now this one you can factor by parts or grouping, or you can simply, when you have the coefficient of 1 in front of x squared, you can simply try to find factors of this last number. We'll call it f of 10, factors of 10 that gives us a sum of 7 of the middle number. Factors of the last number that gives us a sum of the middle number. And what we're trying to do, we're trying to factor this into two binomials. Now the x squared, this first term, splits up into the first place in each parentheses, x times x. The factors of 10 split up into the last place, but they have to be the correct factors of 10 that add up to be 7. So let's look at the factors of 10, the pairs of the ways I can multiply to get 10. 1 times 10, well that would add up to be 11. 2 times 5, that pair would add up to be 7. So this is the correct pair that we're looking for. And we just kind of fill in right here. Plus 2, plus 5, and that's our answer. Now we can check our factoring problems by multiplying these back out. And we multiply these back out by using FOIL or the distributive property. So we'll take this x and multiply it times this x is x squared. This x times 5 is 5x. 2 times x is 2x, and then 2 times 5 is 10. Add those like terms up in the middle, and what do you know? That's what we started off with. X squared plus 7x plus 10, so it checks out. Okay? Now that's a little bit different when you have a number in front of x squared. A few different methods that you can use, trial and error, the AC method, grouping, a few different methods that you could use. The first thing that I see here, though, is that they all have a common factor of 2. So I can factor out a 2. And when you do that, you're just simply dividing that 2 out of each one of your terms, and you'll place a 2 on the outside of a set of parentheses. So when I divide that by 2, I get 12x squared plus 17x plus 6. Okay, that helped me out somewhat. That made my number smaller, but I still have this trinomial, and I need to see if I can factor this trinomial here. Now, in this case, I have a different number in front of x squared besides 1. I have a 12 there, so we can't do it like we did the last problem. I'm going to do it by what I call using the AC method, and you'll hear it factoring by parts or factoring by grouping. The first thing we have to do is multiply this first number times this last number. And then we're going to use kind of the same mindset as what we used on the last problem. We're going to find factors of that product, which is 72, that will give us a sum of 17. And some of you may know this right off the bat, but if not, then that's fine. Just start going through your pairs of ways to multiply to get 72. 1 times 72 will give me 73. 2 times 26 will give me 28. 3 times 24 will give me 27. 4 times 18 added up together will give me 22. 6 times 12 will give me 18. So I keep getting closer to 17. And finally, 8 times 9. Well, that gives me that 17. So what we have to do now, and again, this takes more steps than the last problem we did, we have to rewrite this problem, and we're going to change the 17x, the middle term, into our two factors that we just found. So we're going to change that 17x into 8x plus 9x. We'll call that splitting that middle term. And what this allows me to do is to do what we call factoring by grouping. So now I can make two groups, and I can factor out the common factor, the greatest common factor out of each one of those groups. And you just notice that 2 is just going to kind of follow us down. So the greatest common factor for 12x squared plus 8x is simply 4x, because 4 will go into both of those, and then they both have an x in common. And just like we did up here, whatever we factor out, we're just going to divide each one of those terms by that to see what's left over. So we get 3x plus 2. The GCF for this group is 3. So we divide out of 3 here, and we get 3x plus 2. Now the key to doing this is having the same binomial with both groups here. And if we have that, we can take that binomial, that like binomial, and write it out one time, that 3x plus 2 one time. And then in another set of parentheses, we're going to write our leftovers. 4x plus 3. And that will be our answer. And I know this takes a lot of steps, and again, you can do it by trial and error. There's also a method you can look up called bottoms up, but you have to, this problem takes a little bit more work than the ones without anything, with the understood one in front of x squared. Okay, so make sure you practice with your factoring and hang in there and keep working hard.